Principal-agent problems are common in finance and describe conflicts of interest between financial service providers, such as lenders and insurance companies, and their clients. There are two important types of principal-agent problems: adverse selection and moral hazard. Adverse selection arises when the principal does not have all the necessary information about the agent, and therefore cannot appropriately control for the differences in risk across agents. In credit markets, lenders are the principal and borrowers are the agents. Lenders worry about lending to high-risk borrowers, who they cannot easily tell apart from low-risk borrowers. How does this problem lead to financial exclusion? If lenders try to protect themselves by demanding collateral, then some low-risk individuals who are too poor to post the necessary collateral won't be able to borrow. Another example of adverse selection is the market for health insurance. Health insurers worry that only unhealthy people who know they will need expensive coverage will buy insurance. The insurer may respond by not offering insurance products, which leads to exclusion. Moral hazard arises when the principal has limited ability to control the agent's actions, and the actions that are best for the agent and the principal are not the same. In credit markets, lenders worry that borrowers will use loans to make risky investments and then default if their investments fail. If lenders try to solve this problem by asking for collateral, then they could exclude poorer clients. Health insurers worry that once people are protected against the cost of illness, they will take less care of their health. This could, again, lead to insurance products not being provided. Another reason for financial exclusion is transaction costs, which are the costs a household must incur to access financial services. The time to get to a bank branch is a transaction cost, which could be substantial in rural areas. Transaction costs also include fees the customer must pay for banking services. These fees arise to help cover the bank's administrative costs. For example, the cost of operating a bank branch, screening customers, and processing payments. If the transaction costs of a financial service are higher than the expected benefits, then households will not use the service. While principal-agent problems and transaction costs increase financial exclusion, it is important to remember that even in the absence of these frictions, some people should be excluded from access to finance because they are too risky. Excluding people because they are too risky is not a problematic form of financial exclusion.